Hey guys, it's Juliet, aka The Mug Life. Welcome to my channel. If you are brand new, I am so excited that you decided to check out my channel and my video. Today, I am actually participating in one of my favorite YouTube collabs. It is called Using Trash to Create Treasure. We have KC, who is our host with Coffee with My Sunshine, and the co-host is April Adair Shares. I will have both of those channels linked down below. And I do have two trash crafts for you today. This first craft that I am doing is I'm just using three different cans, and I decided to give them a faux galvanized paint, something I loved doing. I always do a medium base first, then I add my darker black paint, and I always paint in kind of a stippling motion with my paintbrush, my white last, because white will blend in the most and I want that to stand out. So I wanted to do a centerpiece in my living room, so I decided to jazz them up a little bit with some red bead garland that I found at the thrift store for $2. I got so many wooden beads. It was such a great find, so be looking out at your thrift store. And I made three little tassels. I wasn't quite sure my entire vision, but I just decided I was gonna kind of go along with it. And here is something I have actually done in another craft, which I'll have linked below, above. Yeah. I take a skewer, a bamboo skewer, and I just lightly glue each bead and I just kind of thread it on there. And then I'll stick it in my floral arrangement. Especially with these red beads, I thought they kind of resembled a holly or just kind of my little strange boho touch. Now I am taking the Dollar Tree ribbon that is the red checkered pattern, but I actually turned it around. This one, I believe it has snowflakes on the side that they show you in glitter, which is not my favorite. So I just turned the ribbon around just to have more of that flat look. And then I wrapped my burlap tassel around the very top and put a few Dollar Tree picks. Now for my second one, I did decide to do two different ribbon accents, one on the very bottom and one on the top. My husband actually asked me what in the world my little pink finger thumb thing I'm wearing, and I told him it's a little silicone mold that I found at the Dollar Tree and it's in the new crafters section. It is, I swear, the best dollar I have ever spent, because you can see a couple times I lightly glue something and I just put my finger right on it and you can hold it down and it's wonderful. It saves my fingerprints basically. So I took one of my Dollar Tree wooden snowflakes and did that on my center one and just glued that down and added some more Dollar Tree picks in that arrangement. And then I'll go on to my third can. Also, don't quite know what I'm doing, just kind of decided I wanted to add a little bit of my favorite lace accent. So I glued at the very top, and then right over top of that, I glued some of the Dollar Tree lace on the very bottom. And see, look, I'm just pushing my finger right on it. It's great. It's almost like instead of a thimble for sewing, it's a awesome craft must have. And this is my centerpiece, how it turned out. I love my, I would say, slightly strange craft idea. I love raffia and all of the natural colors with the burlap. And these picks with the, almost it's like an icicle branch. I couldn't believe they were at the Dollar Tree. I just really, really, really loved them. Pointing out is I love using unusual textures in my crafts. I would say don't be afraid to mix and match colors or textures. Just go with whatever makes you happy. I really love classic Christmas colors, and I really thought the raffia kind of reminded me of hay. So if you think it can definitely reminisce of Jesus's manger and the hay, go ahead and raffia it up along with me. Now for my second trash to treasure, I am actually going to be recycling this Puffs container. I do not know what these are, but I loved the shape of it and I thought this would be a perfect craft as a gift for a teacher or a friend or just anyone, and you'll see how I create this little snowman using my puffs container. I hot glued the very top to a piece of scrap cardboard that I had, and I'm taking one of the Dollar Tree scarves and I just cut right down the center of it, just the size that I wanted. I do adjust it a little bit, and I even frayed the edges to kind of give it the effect of a knit scarf, even though it's not technically a knit scarf. And I folded that in half and wrapped it around the middle section of my little snowman, and then I glued that on to make sure that it would stay nice and secure. Now I just hot glued three little dots and added some really cute green buttons that I had. I do know the Dollar Tree carries buttons as well, so you can always add a little bit of an embellishment with the color. I chose the green because I wanted the classic colors. And then I just drew on the eyes, just some round little circles. And this next step, I am going to be building up my snowman hat. I did go with a classic little top hat, and I am going to recycle this Parmesan plastic container. They had lines on it. I thought it would be really great to just cut along, and I went to two little lines, and then I just hot glued that right to it. And of course, I'm just painting. I'm very spastic when I'm crafting. I go from one thing to the next. Actually, I believe I am dotting my little coals for the mouth. I just flip my paintbrush over and just add those right there. The next part that I started painting was my little carrot nose. I just basically did a little triangle at a slight angle. Now I decided to go back to my top hat, and I am just gluing pretty heavily my Parmesan top to the cardboard that I had already painted. And then I went ahead and painted the top while the glue was still pretty hot. And I went most of the way down, and then I decided I wanted to add some ribbon. So I took my little snowflake checkered red ribbon that I got from the Dollar Tree, also a little bit of greenery, and just trimmed that down, and while the glue was hot, used that and glued it to my hat. Now, I didn't think my snowman was quite complete without some snow. So I just dry brushed a little bit of white paint around it, and I bought one of these packs of the glitter snow from Dollar Tree, not knowing what I was gonna do with it, and I thought it looked really cute. I liked the shimmer and shine to it, so I added it all around. And those are my Trash to Treasure crafts that I created. I really hope you guys enjoyed, maybe a little bit outside the box, but I had so much fun making them, and I probably will be making these for an upcoming craft show for any kind of teachers or friends or just anybody who would really like this snowman as part of their Christmas decor. Thanks guys, I really hope you will subscribe and like and comment below which craft was your favorite, the snowman or the faux galvanized tin. I'm slightly partial to my snowman. To all my recycled crafters, see you next time.